Here's 8 Pokemon Go tips that only top level players use. Some of these may be annoying and require some patience, but in the long run, they always pay off. Number one is going to be syncing your 7-day catch and spin streak, adventure sync rewards, and your research box. Every Monday on 9 a.m. local time, you will get your adventure sync rewards for the past week, and the rewards will vary depending on how far you walk. If you are to sync your 7-day catch streak and your 7-day spin streak, as well as your research box all on Monday at 9 a.m., use a star piece, use a lucky egg, you can take advantage of a lot of Stardust and XP gains. To sync this up, do not catch or spin a Pokestop on a certain Monday, and both your streaks will reset to start on Tuesday. Then catch and spin stops for the next 7 days, and it'll all line up on Monday at 9 a.m. To sync up your research box, you want to miss out on doing research certain days until every single day you can get a single stamp of research, and it'll all line up to a certain Monday. Do all this and then claim everything on Monday at 9 a.m. with a star piece and a lucky egg, and you can get some big gains. Number two is going to be using AR mode. The top trainers in the world use AR mode because it's faster to catch Pokemon. Let's take a look at a regular encounter. The Pokemon appears, scrolls back, nothing special. In AR mode though, when I get an encounter, the Pokeball instantly appears and I can instantly throw that Pokeball. This allows hardcore trainers to catch Pokemon way faster because that Pokemon is instantly appearing. The only downside is you do have to hold your phone upright like this because AR mode does use gyroscope. So if I hold my phone down like this, I'm literally just gonna throw Pokeballs at the floor. It can be tedious to do, but helps you in catching more Pokemon during a certain day. Next up is stacking research tasks. If you complete a field research task and get a Pokemon encounter, but then you run from it, it'll get thrown in your stack tasks here at the top, as you can see. Stack tasks are a long list of back-to-back encounters you can encounter at a later date. What a lot of trainers do is they will stack stage 1 Pokemon, stage 2 Pokemon, or Pokemon that gets you extra Stardust and save them for 2x catch Stardust or 3x catch Stardust events. For example, this Charmeleon I have in my stack task here does get me 300 base Stardust per catch. If I wait till a 3x catch XP event, I can get 900 Stardust from this Charmeleon encounter. It does take some patience in stacking the Pokemon by running from them and then waiting for these events, but in the long run, doing these kind of techniques can help you out. Some people even stack Pokemon they want extra candy for and wait for 2x catch candy events to take advantage. Next up is going to be saving and using quick delete search threads. If you search a certain search thread, for example, shiny and age 0, and when you back out of that, click the search, click see more, it'll be in your recents. Long hold on that and it'll get thrown into your favorite search threads. You can then go ahead into that search thread and rename it whatever you would like. The top players in the world create quick delete search threads, filtering out any Pokemon they want to keep. For example, I'm going to search age 0 and not Buzel. This will filter out all of my Buzels that I have caught in the last 24 hours and only show me the other Pokemon. Once you have all the Pokemon you don't want to transfer in there, you can go ahead and select all and transfer all of them. This is a top tip for hardcore trainers to quickly delete Pokemon on the go during events by filtering out the Pokemon they want to keep and transferring everything else. Again, it's even faster if you go ahead and save it in your favorite search thread so you can quickly click on it and have that search thread pop up and quick delete. Next up, burying gyms. Burying can be one of the most gruesome tasks and slow tasks in the game, but it can get you so much Stardust. The top trainers in the world will give berries to as many Pokemon in gyms as they can. You get 20 Stardust every time you bury a Pokemon in a gym, and you can give up to 10 Pokemon 10 berries every 30 minutes. Top trainers in the world will go into their Pokemon currently in gyms, feed the 10 Pokemon the 10 berries, set a 30-minute timer, and then do it again. If you do that for 10 hours straight and not miss a single timer, that's an extra 40,000 Stardust every single day just from burying Pokemon. It does take a lot of berries, so you do have to have those on standby by spinning gyms and stuff. The amount of extra stars you can get from just setting that timer and burying those Pokemon is extremely beneficial. Let's talk about trading. Trading is one of the most boring things to do in Pokemon Go. They have not added a lot of quality of life updates to make it fast. It generally takes about an hour to do the max of 100 trades every single day, and I recommend doing it. I know it's super gruesome, but trading gets you extra candy and XL candy for trading away Pokemon. Do a max of 100 trades every single day, and that's an extra 700 XL candy for a specific Pokemon every single week. 700 XL candy is maxing out at least 2 Pokemon to level 50. I also recommend you do your special trade every day by mirror trading a past Community Day Shiny. My mom literally got a Shundo Gibble from a random lucky trade a couple days ago just by doing my special trade every single day. Moving on to number 7, and it's going to be not evolving all the way. I know when you get a new Pokemon, you just want to spam that evolve button, get it in your Pokedex, but the top trainers in the world do not just evolve Pokemon for no reason. Reason being is certain Pokemon already have legacy moves in Pokemon Go from past Community Days, for example, Rockwrecker, Rhyperior, and certain Pokemon may get legacy moves. If you don't know how legacy moves generally work in Pokemon Go, you can either use an Elite Charge TM or Elite Fast TM to teach them, or certain events will allow you to evolve the middle stage into the final stage to instantly learn that legacy move. So it's beneficial to never evolve your Pokemon right away in case in the future Pokemon get Community Days or there's another opportunity to get their past legacy moves. This saves you so many Elite TMs in the long run. Do not evolve Pokemon unless absolutely necessary. And that brings us to the final tip, and that is going to be gymming every day. No matter if you're the top player in the the world or just getting started, gymming every day is essential to do. Never sleep on Pokecoins. You can get 50 free Pokecoins every single day by just having a Pokemon in gym for at least 8 hours. Even at the highest level, these Pokecoins come in so clutch to buy raid passes, to buy item bag and storage space if you're not maxed out. So gym every single day, make sure you drop those Pokemon in gyms. That is pretty much it, guys. 8 tips only hardcore players use in Pokemon Go. Make sure you're taking advantage of this. I know some of these are really annoying to do and take a lot of extra time, like trying to sync up your streak. But once it's all synced up, you can take huge advantage and get huge gains and make your account jump leaps and bounds ahead. Comment below if there's any other tips you think I missed in this video that the top level trainers use in the world. We're gonna see you on the next one. Follow for more tips, everyone. Peace.